anatomy of the prostate. The prostate is a fibromuscular-glandular organ. Lies just below the bladder neck. The prostate is pyramidal in shape, with its apex directed downward, and its base, the base of the pyramid, is directed upward. And it has three surfaces. The three surfaces are this is the pyramidal shaped structure, the prostate, which has a base upward, apex downward, and it has three surfaces: posterior surface and two surfaces are directed like that towards the pelvic floor, like the urinary bladder. These two surfaces are directed inferiorly but also directed laterally. Therefore, these two surfaces, like the bladder, are called infralateral surfaces. What is the relation of the prostate? Anteriorly. Anteriorly, we are related to the symphysis pubis and the back of the pubic bone. And the prostate is connected to the back of the pubic bone by ligaments. Ligaments between the pubic bone and the prostate. What is the name of these ligaments? Prostate, pubic bone. Therefore, these two ligaments sure are called pubo-prostatic ligaments, which bound a space, deep space called retropubic space or cave of radius. These are the ligaments between the pubic bone and the base of the prostate and the bladder neck are called pubo-prostatic ligaments. And this depression between the ligaments is called cave of radius or retropubic space. For imagination, the retropubic space are two medial and two lateral. Like that, two medial and two lateral. And in between, there is a depression. Depression behind the pubic bone. Therefore, it is called retropubic space or cave of radius. For the Arabic student, قالوا على الحتة اللي تحت دي الحفرة اللي تحت دي شبه الكهف واللي وصفها عالم اسمه ريديوس فقالوا عليها الكهف بتاع الراجل ده cave of radius. This is the anterior relation. Pubic bone, retropubic space, and pubo-prostatic ligament. What is the posterior relation? Posterior relation is this. What is this? Posterior to the prostate, there is the ampulla of the rectum, and separated from the ampulla of the rectum by a dense fascia. This fascia is called the fascia of Dunnan-Villiers, or simply rectovesical fascia. It is called retrovesical fascia because it lies between the urinary bladder and the prostate anteriorly and the rectum posteriorly. Therefore, called rectovesical fascia, between the recto and between the vesico, which is the bladder. Therefore, it's called rectovesical fascia or Dunnan-Villiers fascia. Um, This is the posterior relation to the prostate, which is ampulla of the rectum and rectovesical fascia. The posterior surface is pierced by the two ejaculatory ducts. The upper part of the posterior surface is pierced by two ejaculatory ducts. Therefore, the posterior relation is two ejaculatory ducts, rectovesical fascia or Dunn-Villiers fascia, and ampulla of the rectum. Superiorly, what is the relation of the prostate? Sure, above there is a bladder neck. Inferiorly, what is below the prostate? Below the prostate are this muscle fibers. The two infralateral surfaces just below the prostate are these muscle fibers of levator inii. These muscle fibers of levator inii support the prostate and elevate the prostate. Therefore, these fibers of levator inii are called levator prostati. Below the prostate also this pouch. What is this pouch? The pouch which contain the external urethral sphincter and the bulbourethral gland, and this pouch is called deep perineal pouch. This is the relation of the prostate on both sides, the infralateral surfaces related to levator prostate, which are part of levator inii, and below the prostate there is the deep perineal pouch. Above there is bladder neck. Anteriorly, symphysis pubis, pubic bone, retropubic space, and pubo-prostatic ligaments. Posteriorly, the posterior surface is projected, is pierced by the two ejaculatory ducts. Posterior to the ejaculatory duct, there is Dunn-Villiers fascia or rectovesical fascia. And posterior to the rectovesical fascia is the ampulla of the rectum. The prostate is divided into zones and loops. In the past, the prostate was divided into loops. And this loop comes from what? From the patient with benign prostatic hyperplasia. The patient with benign prostatic hyperplasia, the hyperplasia and the tumor appear as nodules, give sensation that the prostate is divided into multiple nodules, and these multiple nodules are considered as loops. And actually, this is wrong. How to describe anatomy on a pathological condition? Therefore, division of prostate into loops is not correct and not present anatomically. This division into loops depends on there are three ducts pass in the prostate. Anteriorly, the prostatic urethra, and posterior to the prostatic urethra, there are two ejaculatory ducts. In the past, the prostate was considered to be divided into five loops. What these five loops? This is the first loop. The tissues in front of the urethra. The tissues in front of the urethra called the anterior loop or isthmus. Anterior loop or isthmus. The tissues between the urethra and the two ejaculatory ducts are called median lobe because it lies in the middle line. Median lobe between the urethra and the two ejaculatory ducts. The median lobe is surrounded on each side by two lateral lobes. And the tissues posterior to the ejaculatory duct are considered as posterior lobe. These are the five lobes of the prostate: anterior lobe, anterior to the urethra, posterior lobe, posterior to the ejaculatory duct. Between the urethra and the ejaculatory duct, there is median or middle lobe. On both sides, there are two lateral lobes. This is benign prostatic hyperplasia. This is normal. There is no lobes, no abnormality. But in benign prostatic hyperplasia, which characterized by nodularity, there is one nodule here behind the urethra called median lobe, and consider as these two lobes on both sides as two lateral lobes. The most anterior tissue considered the anterior, and the most posterior tissue are considered the posterior lobe. And this is scientifically wrong how to describe anatomy on a pathological condition. Actually, it was found that in normal individual, in normal young, without any benign prostatic hyperplasia, it was found that there are four histological zones. The four histological zones are anterior fibromuscular zone. All the anterior zone is muscle fibers and fibrous tissue. Therefore, it is anterior fibromuscular zone. And there is a zone around the urethra. Therefore, this zone around the urethra is called periurethral zone. This periurethral zone is called pathologically the adenomatous zone because benign prostatic hyperplasia arises from this zone. The periurethral zone and the periurethral glands. In the periphery, the peripheral part of the prostate is called the peripheral zone. This peripheral zone pathologically is called the carcinomatous zone. The carcinomatous zone because carcinoma of the prostate arises from this zone. In between the peripheral zone and the periurethral zone, there is in between the two. Therefore, this zone is called central zone or intermediate zone. This central zone, which is projected by the two ejaculatory ducts. Therefore, four histological zones normally present in normal prostate: anterior fibromuscular, periurethral zone or adenomatous zone because benign prostatic hyperplasia and the adenoma arise from here. Peripheral zone or carcinomatous zone because carcinoma of the prostate arises from this zone. In between and in the center of the prostate, there is central zone or intermediate zone in which passing the two ejaculatory duct. Drawing is very beautiful for the zones of the prostate. Anterior, this is a cut section in the prostate, and this is the anterior fibromuscular zone containing no acini or little acini. Around the urethra, there is central zone. There is periurethral zone, sorry. And in the periphery, there is peripheral zone of the acini. And in the center, there is central zone. These are the division of the prostate. In the past, was divided into five loops, or actually it is divided into now histological four zones. What are the capsules of the prostate? As any organ, sure, the prostate has two inner fibromuscular capsules. As any organ, which gives the organ its shape, the prostate is surrounded by a true fibromuscular capsule. Around this, below, true capsule, condensation of surrounding pelvic fascia occur around the prostate. This condensation of surrounding pelvic fascia, which is the yellow color, represent what is called prostatic sheath. Prostatic sheath is false capsule, false outer capsule, condensation of pelvic fascia. And this prostatic sheath is connected to the back of the pubic bone by the puboprostatic ligaments. Between the two capsules, between the true capsule, which is blue, and the yellowish outer prostatic sheath, present the venous drainage of the prostate, which is the prostatic venous plexus. Between the two capsules, and we'll return to this point within few minutes. This is very important, that between the two capsules is the prostatic venous plexus. What are the structures inside the prostate? Inside the prostate, this is a big cut section in the prostate. Inside the prostate, pass three ducts or three tubes. Sure, anteriorly, this large tube, which is the prostatic urethra. The prostatic urethra enters the prostate at its base and pass downward and forward in the prostate to leave the prostate where? Just above the apex of the prostate. This is the prostate here. The prostatic urethra enters the prostate at its apex. I will magnify this picture. The prostatic urethra enters the prostate at its apex, at its base, and leave the prostate just above its apex. And the prostatic urethra runs in the prostate downward and forward from the base to just above and anterior to the apex of the prostate. the prostatic urethra receive in its posterior wall the opening of these two ducts. Two ducts pierce the upper part of the posterior surface of the prostate. These two ducts are the ejaculatory ducts, which carry the semen to the urethra to be ejaculated to the outside. The two ejaculatory ducts enter the upper part of the posterior surface of the prostate and runs downward and forward to open in the posterior part of the prostatic urethra. Where the open? The open here. This is a very beautiful picture for the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra. In the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra, there are two openings here of the ejaculatory ducts. It is more prominent here, two openings of the ejaculatory ducts. And what is this opening? This is the fourth structure inside the prostate. A small saccule, embryological remnant of what is called paramesonephric duct. Embryological remnant from paramesonephric duct forming a very small saccule project into the prostate upward and backward and called prostatic utricle. This is the ejaculatory duct and this very small saccule projecting from the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra upward and backward into the middle lobe of the prostate called prostatic utricle, and this is just an embryological remnant of paramesonephric duct. Therefore, there are four structures passing in the prostate: the prostatic urethra is the largest and the most important, and open in the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra two ejaculatory duct and the prostatic utricle. And this is view to the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra receiving the other two structures, the two ejaculatory duct, and this is the opening of the prostatic utricle. The prostate is mainly gland, secrete prostatic fluid, which form a part of the semen. The semen consists of prostatic fluid, secretions from seminal vesicles, sure consists of sperms. Therefore, these are the openings of the prostatic glands into the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra. Therefore, the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra receive the openings of the prostatic glands, and in the middle of the posterior wall of the prostatic urethra receive three openings of two ejaculatory duct and the opening of the prostatic utricle. This cut section is very important to imagine the structures inside the prostate. The structures inside the prostate anteriorly prostatic urethra. The posterior wall of the prostatic urethra receive in the middle opening of prostatic utricle, which is a small saccule and embryological remnant of paramesonephric duct. On both sides of the opening of the prostatic utricle, there are the openings of the two ejaculatory ducts. Lateral to the opening of the cryotoducts, there are the openings, multiple openings of the prostatic glands to excrete their secretions here during ejaculation to form a part of the semen. These are the anatomical relation, capsules, and structures inside the prostate. We will continue anatomy of the prostate in the next video. Second, thank you for good listening and good luck.